friends, good morning. In my previous video lecture, I had explained high voltage Keeling bridge to determine the insulation resistance, capacitance and loss factor of the insulation. The high voltage Keeling bridge method has three major drawbacks or limitations. Number one, we require high voltage transformer as well as standard capacitor which we should be rated for 10 kV. So obviously when we require the components of high voltage rating, the cost is more. Second, in order to avoid the electromagnetic interference, we require electromagnetic shielding. Number three is for R3, if R3 value is large, then inherent capacitance and inductance, they cause error in measurement. So error is generated in the measurement. So these are the three basic drawbacks of high voltage Keeling bridge method. So we go for another method, that is transformer ratio arm bridge. Now this transformer ratio arm bridge operates at low voltage, relatively low voltage, or as compared to 10 kV, voltage is very less, it is around 500 volts only. So here we require a transformer rated for 230 volts by 500 volts normally. Again there are now four arms and this is the detector. Now this detector is not CR, it is null detector type of detector. So here we keep the here we keep the test specimen. I am representing this by a parallel combination of resistance and capacitance, resistance branch and capacitance branch. Now we go on adjusting these values till we get null in this detector. So at balance, NS, this is number of turns divided by NP, these are number of turns, will be equal to voltage induced here divided by voltage induced here, that is Vs upon Vp, that will be equal to Vs is across this standard capacitance, so it will be 1 upon V standard, and Vp is across this capacitance, so it will be 1 upon Cp. So we take the, if we simplify this, we get Cp upon C standard. So NF, NP or Vs, Vp are known, C standard is known, so you can compute the value of Cp. Also at null point, NP upon NA, this is NP upon NA, that is this voltage, this number of turns will be equal to Vp upon Va, that is nothing but Rp upon Ra. So Rp is unknown, so it will be Ra into Vp upon Va or Rp into NP upon NA. So in this way we get the value of NP and Cp. So once we get Rp and Cp, we can find out tan delta, that is 1 upon omega Rp Cp. So this is a simple method. Normally it is used for the laboratory purpose. Now there is one drawback of this method, and that is when we are using transformer, there is always phase angle and magnitude error. Ratio and phase angle errors are always there. So those errors will be reflected in the measurement. Now in previous method also we are using a transformer. So that method is also not free from ratio and phase angle error. So that is all about the measurement of tan delta, that is loss factor. Now I will take one numerical to explain the high voltage Keeling bridge method. Numerical on high voltage Keeling bridge to compute Rp, Cp and tan delta. Alternatively to compute Rs, Cs and tan delta. Numerical is a 10 kV 50 Hz Keeling bridge is used to measure the capacitance and loss angle of high voltage machine. At balance, the observations are as under. C standard 100 picofarad. Now I request you to make one change in my previous video lecture. In previous video lecture, I had given the value for standard capacitor as 100 microfarad 10 kV. Actually, it should be 100 picofarad and 10 kV. In place of 100 microfarad, make it 100 picofarad. So, C standard is 100 picofarad. Obviously, it will be 10 kV. Variable resistance setting. Variable resistance means R3, that is 636 ohms. Variable capacitor setting 0.00125 microfarad. So, this will be C4. Fixed resistor in parallel with variable capacitor. So, it will be CR4, 3180 ohms. Compute the parameters of machine and loss factor assuming parallel representation of the parameters. Second part, compute the same assuming series combination of the parameters. Now here one important thing is, in the bridge which I had explained, nomenclatures were R3, C4 and R4. In some books, it may be R4, C3 and R3. So accordingly, you have to substitute the values for computation. Now in my computation, this formula I had used, Rp is R3 upon omega square, C standard, C4 into R4 square, Cp is C standard multiplied by R4 upon R3, and tan delta is omega R4 C4. So I will use these equations for computation. For series combination, I have used the formula R3 C4 upon C standard, Cf is C standard into R4 upon R3, and tan delta is omega R4 C4. So these equations I will use in part B. So with parallel combination, R5 is R3 upon omega square, omega square is 2 pi f square, multiplied by C standard, that is 100 picofarad, multiplied by C4, that is 0.00125 into 10 to the power minus 6 farads. All the values you have to take in ohms and farads, and R4 is 3180 square. So Rp we are getting 5098 mega ohms. Cp is C standard multiplied by R4 divided by R3. So we are substituting the values and we are getting this value as 5 into 10 to the power minus 10 farads, that is 0.5 nanofarad. Now tan delta is omega R4 into C4. So we are getting it 1.25 into 10 to the power minus 3. Hence delta is 0.07154 radians. For series combination, Rs is, this is R3 multiplied by C4 upon C standard. So this is C4, this is C standard. So Rs we are getting 7950 ohms. Formula for Cs and Cp is same. So we are getting this 0.5 nanofarads. And tan delta is same, omega R4 C4, we are getting same value, 1.25 into 10 to the power minus 3. Now you can check the value of tan delta by formula here, 1 upon omega Rp Cp, and here you can check the value of tan delta by formula omega Rs into Cs. You must get same values for tan delta. So this is all about high voltage shearing bridge. Friends, if you feel this video lecture useful, then please like it, subscribe to my channel, ask your friends, colleagues and juniors to subscribe to my channel for upcoming video lectures on high voltage engineering and power system protection. If you want to make effective and efficient use of time, then read my book on time management. The link for the book is given in the description box. I will launch a useful course for the students on Udemy. This course is very useful for the students who are appearing for competitive and entrance exams. The link for the course is also given in the description box. In my next video lecture, I will explain the partial discharge measurement techniques. Thank you.